Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. A warm welcome to all of you for this session, for this event, great event. I've been honored to be part of this great event. I should thank ICTAC for again inviting me for this great event. I've been associated with ICTAC for a couple of years, and it's an opportunity for me to be here to share my thoughts. And once again, thank to Shivakumar sir, a very warm, friendly person. I know him for a couple of years, and welcome to my known friends who are all of them here, and my HR folks who have been here from morning. Being a weekday, there's a lot of work at office, I know that. So many of them have come here right from colleges to organizations, and being a week, end of the week, Friday, there's a lot of deliverables which you have to do simultaneously. I could see many of you working simultaneously in your mobile, sending messages and all that. Thanks to all of you, and thank you very much for inviting me for this session. And I usually just Shivakumar sir puts me always after lunch. The session always he puts me after the lunch. I usually tell him this is the most difficult time to handle the crowd, and he offers the best of the food. And you know, Andhra style food, it was, I was not able to eat because I had my presentation. So, and sometimes in the last session where everybody's about to leave, so I usually tell him, why is this you're doing? Anyway, it's an opportunity. Thank you very much, sir. And it was a wonderful introduction about me. Thank you very much. And I come from the organization called Technosoft. It's an MNC, US-based multinational. We are close to around 5,000 employees across India, all locations, and across the world. We are a US-based. We are in UK, China, Middle East, Australia, and Canada. And we are into four verticals. We are into IT services, we are into BPM healthcare, we are into GIC, that is Global In-House Center, which is resource augmentation model, and we are into professional staffing. We are the only mid-sized company which are into these four verticals. Even bigger companies, they are into two verticals, but being a mid-sized company, we are into four verticals. I head all the four verticals, global head for Technosoft. I've been with this organization for the past 8 years. Wonderful organization. It's a baby which I have nurtured, and a lovely organization. Work-life balance is fantastic at our organization. And second thing is, before I get into the session, I've been associated with ICTAC. ICTAC has been doing a lot of initiatives. I've been part of ICTAC, which is the main bridge between the institutes and corporates. They've been doing a wonderful work for the past so many years, so many events, so many campuses, and it is very much required, and they've been doing this seamlessly and religiously. Whatever may be, I think they need a huge applause. Okay, today's session, I think from morning, you've been hearing about learning, developing, nurturing, talents, skills. So many speakers, experts from the industry was giving a lot of inputs, and you've been hearing about this from morning. One thing all about this session is I'm going to have a very interactive session. It's not going to be a PPT. I'm not going to put any PPT. I'll give you some data points and I'll share my experience. And also one thing is we have come all the way from all the places gathered here at Vijayawada is for a purpose. It's for a cause. It's not just a session or an event which has been organized. Every year it has been organized and we finish, we have lunch, some takeaways, knowledge, and tomorrow we forget. It should not be like that. This session is for a cause, for a purpose which we have gathered here. And in this session, please don't take it defensive or don't take it to your heart. We have gathered for a purpose. We have to discuss. We need to see what are our gaps. As a corporate, what gaps we have. As an institute, what gaps you have. As students, what are the gaps? These are the three areas which we need to see and find out what is the gap. So, there's nothing to pinpoint. It's more of a sharing. Don't take it defensive. This session, from morning, probably we've been hearing about what the students should possess. What the students should have. How to develop them. And my session talks about cultivating the community of talent. So it is not talking about only the student, but it is talking about all the three communities. One is the institute, the college. One is the corporate. And one is the student community. One thing which I see, the trend keeps changing. I don't want to repeat or talk about what has been spoken, discussed last year or 6 months back because things are changing at a very fast manner. We have been talking about skills, development and all that. Today's session, I'm going to talk about what skills is missing with this particular community. I'm going to talk about the placements cell and the faculties of the college. I think Mr. Surya Prakash, he had a lot of data points, excellent data points. What is missing is the curriculum, the faculties, the placements. 5 important areas which I am going to talk about. One is some data points for you to remember where we stand. Some industry trends which I wanted to tell you. And what are the gaps we have? And then probably some takeaways. So with data points, you know where our institutes stand worldwide? We have been getting a lot of news data at recent times. Indian universities, Indian institutes, compared to the global institutes, where we were and what we are now. It was a very recent statistics which was given. Anybody from this? Where we stand, Indian institutes at the moment. I'm talking about the big B's. I don't want to name here, but our top institutes. We are nowhere in the 10th. We are nowhere in the 20th. We are nowhere in the 30th. we are nowhere in the 50th also. We are in the 68th position. 68. We have gone somewhere lost. This is really a very, very saddening, very sad to tell you that we are in the 68th position among the global institutes. Imagine our education system, which has been ranked, it's pathetic. You know, overall graduates passing in India, any numbers? 1.5 million. Engineers passing out close to around 12 lakhs. You know what is our unemployed engineers? Any guesses? Unemployed engineers. And my dear, placement heads, institute heads, we produce 100 times of UK universities, 100 times of engineers we produce in a year. Do you believe that? 100 times compared to UK. Pardon? And you know what is our unemployed engineers? It is 60%. Only 40% of our engineers are getting employment. 60% are unemployed. Isn't it very saddening? Have we thought through this? What we are missing? Where we are missing? In this, you will not believe, 3% of our engineering students, their suitable skills is employable in a software industry. Only 3% of our engineering students suit to the software industry. See, this is, we need to think about it. And one more information which we need to know, we were talking about training and all that. You know what is the gap between the institute and the companies? Training institutes are in the dark. 84% of the training institutes, this is the latest data, 84% of the training institutes are in the dark. They don't know what to be trained, what is needed for a company, a software industry. They are totally in the dark, 84%. 36% of the colleges are disconnected with the hiring strategies. These are all data which has been taken from our Indian market. I would want you to watch a small video. We will stop it in between. I think most of you would have seen this WhatsApp video. We'll just play it. What we infer from that is what I want to know. Can you please play that?
Italian, German, Arabic,
can
Irani,
you, can you show me?
Which language?
French.
C'est la M des ponts, c'est la 50 pi, c'est joli. C'est la M des ponts, c'est la 1 euro, c'est joli, c'est la 50 pi. 50 pi, c'est la M des ponts. C'est joli, right?
Okay, yeah, yeah.
After Italian.
Italian.
Pasta bello, paone, c'è lo 50 rupia uno, sto bonito paone. Buono, bonito, barato, mira, te che sto uno paone, 50 rupia. Sta bello. After German, pan frida, wunderbar. Fum si supian, c'è il schul, wunderbar. Fum si supian, 1 euro. After RB, Lala Taus Kardi Kupana Chan, Ada Kamsi, Ada Chan Bagatalat Mia Kamsi. After Hirani, After Russian, Paulin Maulin, Pishat Rupi, Ada Ruski Raska Punargi, the Pishat Rupi, Ada Tiris Pishat, Ada Krosha Pishat Rupi. After Japanese, Kujakuno, Mini Mini Natakai, Korewanu Gojurupini, Korewanu Haku Gojune, Sayonarani.
How did you learn all this stuff?
I am selling every tourist coming because every tourist coming the here, every country people coming because I am selling every language. Five, six talking language, every language because I selling.
What about Arabic?
Arabic, Baba thousand Arabic people here, so many coming, many ranches and coming, Arabic, Hirani.
Can you speak Arabic?
Arabic, yeah, Lala thousand Kardi Chan Baba. Comes in, other Tilat Mia comes in, other comes in, other Mia comes in. Ada Chan Baba Taus.
That's really good.
After 1 minute, there's a hanging garden. You know why I call this hanging garden?
No, right.
Inside in the water tank, the garden, 30 million gallons.
Have you seen this video? He's a 9-year-old, a poor boy who sells. You could see he's on the streets. Who sells to the tourists in Mumbai. He knows 7-8 foreign languages. What is the need for him? One is his passion. Passion to succeed. Do you think all of them will know all these foreign languages? Do we know our Indian languages more than 3-4 languages? What is the need for a 9-year? His perfectness, his attitude, and his passion. This is what is required at this age. See his body language, see his confidence. When a 9-year can develop this, why not our students? See, one thing is what we are looking at is number of offers. We are all looking at how many offers we can roll out from one organization, from one institute. My dear placements, heads, one is it is not that we sell numbers, but we sell quality. These are products, our students. What is going to happen to their career? We get the offers because one is I know that HR. I know very well. So we'll push offers. 100 offers, 200 offers. You put it there, 200 offers from X company, 300 offers from Y companies. But are we giving quality? What is the need? Have you found out what is the need from the organization? You know what is the trend, current trend? It is no more HR decision at all. And moreover, when a technical team comes to evaluate your students, and when they go back to the corporate, when at the time of joining, they are going to be evaluated by a different team totally. The candidates who have got 100 offers or 200 offers, when they go there, they become incapable when they get evaluated by the technical team because it is more domain, it is more technology. Nowadays, all corporates are looking at technology. Communication and all that soft skill, everything is gone. Of course, qualification, no way. We are looking for an attitude, positive attitude, whether this candidate will adapt to the organization and technology. Now, everything is technology, my dear friends. It's all technology driven. The C, C++, it's so pathetic. We did campuses. Students are not able to clear even the C, C++ basic things. That is the status of our education system. We are still sitting on C, C++. What is our latest technology? Are you aware of it? I want an information-based placement heads, placement cell, colleges should have information. What is the latest technology in the industry? Are your faculties trained on this technology? We will have the discussion. Let us finish. No, correct. Okay.
Detailed way, and I am totally disagreeing with your statistics. I don't know where you took the statistics. Very sorry to say, 3%, it is not at all correct. 3% of engineering students getting employment. I think everyone, if you agree with my statistics, please give a big round of applause, because as morning one speaker said that, so you took it in a positive way instead of a negative way. So we are giving employment to 18% to 23% engineers. So I have a statistics. If you want, I will give state-wise statistics also to you.
No.
So 23% is the average.
Average
engineering, these things.
I wanted to know your name.
My name is Professor Venkatrav. I am representing Gayatri Vidyapeeth College of Engineering,
okay. Mr. Venkatrav.
And I am representing APT Pro Consortium.
See, this session, I wanted to give, what is the expectation? And it is not, I told you from the beginning, it is not debate, and we can brainstorm this. Please take it in a very positive sense. There's nothing to do with, if we have a gap, let's correct it. No. I'm not saying that you're wrong. I'm not saying you're wrong. This is a session where you want to take things, you take it. You want to leave out things, you can leave it. It's definitely what a corporate and organization is looking at. I'm looking at what is the gap. I'm not defending or saying our.
Sure, sir.
No, see, I told you already, we have come for a cause, to fight for a cause. If everything is going to be spoken, oh, this is fantastic, we have been doing a great job, our campuses are superb, our numbers are superb, this is not the session for that. We have come here to discuss a problem, a cause, we have to discuss about that. If we are going to appreciate each other, we are not going to discuss about any cause here. And if you want to take things, take it. If you don't want, let's leave it. This is what is our corporate expectation. Simple as that.
Sir.
Sure. I think. Sure. We will have some time in the next panel for some discussion. Let this session continue, sir. Thank you.
There's nothing harm at all. See, you can definitely voice out. This is just a takeaway. Don't take it in a very... I told you in the beginning itself, there's no debate at all. There's no question of you are doing a right thing, I'm doing a right thing. There are also negatives about corporates. I told you about that. So, corporate keeps changing. It is very dynamic. We have to adapt to the corporate. If we tell corporate, please change your ideas, your viewpoints or your process, they are not going to change. But only the institutes, only the students have to mold themselves because you have to get the employment.
Sir, so we have a panel discussion, sir, where we can debate and we can brainstorm much more things. So let's allow Dr. Jude to continue with this.
So we spoke about the students. One is students are to be molded. They are like the clay. So they have come to our hands. It is our responsibility to mold them. The clay doesn't have anything. It is fit for nothing. Our parents, all of you, you were knowledgeable when you came into your education or nursery. You are all qualified doctors. Who has molded you? The college, school, everything has molded you. How is it possible? It all depends on our hands, how to mold them. Don't please blame the system. System always be bad. But from that, how we are going to come? When we have been molded, why not our students? They are clays. Please mold them. That's our responsibility. As a corporate, it's my responsibility. As an institute, it's your responsibility. Don't say the system is bad. We are getting only this kind of students. No way. If we keep blaming, nothing is going to change. No, sir. There's no debate at all. Let's finish it. We'll have a brainstorming session. Please have that discussion. I'm not saying anything wrong. I'm saying we have to take things in hand. There is a problem. Let's resolve it as a collective thing. Colleges. In fact, Mr. Surya was talking about how many of our faculties are being trained on technology. The latest technology. What is our latest technology? What is the latest technology? Can anybody, sir, can you please tell what are the latest technology you have trained in your colleges? For your faculties. Okay, thank you, sir. Sir has been doing lot of trainings for their students. I think it's one of the best practices which he's been doing for his college. Sir, there's a lot of things. That's what I asked you. I got your information. Thank you very much. So, one is please have these best practices. One is for your faculties. Faculties have to be trained on latest technologies. Students, we are looking for, now the corporates have become plug and play. There is no more the training concept at all. Inducting the students, now it's become an on-the-job training. In fact, in Technosoft, what we have done is, we made the students to do a project. When we offered these candidates, all of them were given projects to do, to implement. Whoever has successfully implemented the projects, they have joined our organization. And many of them did their job, succeeded, they went, learned, they did the project. Some of the students, of course, they didn't show interest. We were not able to take them. We gave them a couple of chances for the interviews, technical interviews. They were not able to do it. But some students, they really put in a lot of effort. They cleared the project and they are there inside the company. So technology is one thing which we are looking at from the students. The right attitude and adaptability is very, very important, which the current organizations are looking at. It is no more marks. Communication, we have forgotten about the communication skills. See, each location has a gap. For example, if we are going to take students from Chennai, communication is not an issue at all. They communicate, but technology-wise, they are weak. If you go in the southern part, Coimbatore, technology-wise, they are strong. But soft skills, they are weak. If you talk about Andhra, technology is weak. They have a right attitude. The students here have a right attitude, the spirit. Everything is there, but when there is an interview, when there is a telecon interview, technical interview, they fumble. We have gone through all the places. It is not that overall, I'm telling you, all the students requires communication, technology training. No, it is based on the location. We also should look at from the location point of view, what is missing. As sir was telling about what is the base education, from which education system they are coming, whether it's a matriculation or a CBSE, which background, you have to analyze each set of students. It is not that overall we cannot comment that they are weak in all the things. No way. Each location students have some kind of gaps, and that can be definitely improved. That can be improved by only by us. We are the molders for them. Parents have come and given it to us. Please get them a job. It is our responsibility to mold them. And if the student has the right attitude to take it and get himself molded, he gets a job. If he doesn't have a right attitude, it is his destiny. You can't help it. But our responsibility is to find the gaps. What is the industry gaps? How we could train them, mold them, and give them. And it's up to them how to clear the interviews and get in. Some of the suggestions which I wanted to give is, do a technology training right from third year. This is some of the inputs which we have implemented and we have successfully done this. Please start the technology training right from third years for your students. That's very, very important. And Also, you can train them post offers. When they get their offers, post that, provide them a complete technology training based on the organization need. Completely put them in the technology training. Because when they go inside the organization, within a week's time or 1 month, they are being sent out. Because they don't meet up to the expectation of technology. Because corporates are looking at plug and play. Because all projects, my dear friends, let me tell you, the projects, current projects which are there, is all temporary projects. 6 months, 8 months. And they have to do upskilling every 6 months, 3 months. All the lateral hires also. It is not only for the freshers. For the lateral hiring, we expect upskilling every 3 months. That's the expectation of industry. If they are not upskilling themselves, they lose the job. Job security is very, very high. With upskilling, job security is there. So you have to keep upgrading technology, whether you are a lateral hire or a fresh hire. Identify institutes. Identify location-based institutes. There's a lot of institutes which are available, which can train our students. Do an exchange program with the companies. All organizations are willing to take people, put them in the projects, live projects. Whoever clears the live project will definitely get a job. No doubt about it. They need not come for campuses. Many companies have come out with the exchange program. A set of students who will be put in the live projects. And if they clear, they are inside. I think we are running short of time. Sir took most of my time. And there's nothing to hurt about anybody. This is what is the expectation of industry. Whether you accept it or not. From morning you've been hearing, telling only positive things. If that cools you, I'm not for it. I've come here to talk about what we need. What is missing from our students. And there is nothing to blame about you. Blame about students. But as a team, we have to address this issue. With this, I just wanted to close this. Thank you very much for this session. And I think I really made you to be alive in this session. Nobody slept except one person I could see, but rest of you were very attentive. Thank you very much for making the session lively.